Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 22, Example 6. In this example, we want to solve the inequality negative 2x plus 5 is less than 11, write our answer in interval notation, and graph the solution set. Note that we solve linear inequalities in the same way that we do linear equations. We want to get our variable on one side by itself and everything else on the other side by using inverse operations. In this problem, it looks like we have several things we need to do to solve this. In step 1, we want to simplify each side if needed. This inequality is already simplified. In step 2, we want to use the addition-subtraction properties of inequalities to move the variable term on one side and all other terms to the other side. When we add or subtract the same thing to both sides of an inequality, the inequality does not change. The inverse of adding 5 is to subtract 5 from both sides, which will give us a negative 2x plus 5 minus 5 is less than 11 minus 5, which simplifies to be negative 2x is less than 6. In step 3, we want to use the multiplication or division property for inequality. A reminder that if we are multiplying or dividing both sides of the inequality by a negative number, the inequality needs to change. If we are multiplying or dividing both sides by a positive value, the inequality stays the same. The inverse of multiplying by negative 2 is to divide both sides by negative 2. When we do this, we will get negative 2x over negative 2, and because we are dividing both sides by negative, we switch the inequality to greater than 6 over negative 2, which will simplify to be x is greater than negative 3, which is our final answer to the inequality part of this problem. Next, let's write this in interval notation. The answer to this inequality is an open interval because we are not including where x is equal to negative 3, just strictly where x is greater than negative 3. Note that since we are not including where x equals negative 3, we will use a curved n on that end, and anytime we have infinity or negative infinity in interval notation, we always use a curved n on that end. So the final answer for the interval notation will be a curved end with negative 3, comma, infinity with another curved n to give us the open interval of negative 3 to infinity. Last, we need to graph this. The graph will look like the interval notation. We will have a curved in at negative 3, and to show everything greater than negative 3, we will shade in everything to the right of negative 3 for our final answer for the graph.